Hey everyone, my name's KJ and I have the honor of being your student pastor here at the chapel. In case you're new tonight, I wanted to personally welcome you to this house party and thank you for taking this step of growing in your faith. I know it may not feel like anything is happening. Sometimes faith is like that. But I believe faith is like a piggy bank. When you get some loose change, you toss it in, and over the course of a long time, it adds up. And each time you drop in some loose change, you add more value to what's inside. Something changes. The same thing applies to your faith. Attending Motion Night or this house party, reading your Bible, or even attending another type of small group or club at school, it all adds up and helps you grow closer to Jesus. Honestly, it may not feel like it now, because growth is rarely ever seen in the moment, right? You never see your grass grow outside. You never see trees grow to the heights they're at. It just happens. Like a piggy bank with 37 cents in it, it's pretty small at the start. But then that 37 cents, I don't know why I picked that, I just picked it. 37 cents grows to a dollar and then $10. And before you know it, what started as baby steps resulted in something pretty amazing. So I'm proud of you. Way to be faithful and way to show up to the Lord and say, hey, I'm here for you. Do what you want to show me. Do what you want to tell me. Do what you will in my life tonight. Way to go. Motion Night was awesome. Wasn't it so great? David Bogert really knocked it out of the park with a message on gratitude. And I'm so thankful that you got a chance to hear from another voice other than mine. I think that's super important because we grow best when we learn from and surround ourselves with different positive influences. And I love this November theme of mood to talk about the topic of gratitude, because gratitude is something we don't really spend a lot of time on. We don't really discuss the thought of gratitude, right, as a culture, as Americans, except for maybe a couple days out of the year in November. But I think we should talk about it. Because like David said at Motion Night, we've never been more inundated with people who complain or, you know, people who have opinions about things. And it takes absolutely zero talent. Hey, zero talent to complain, whine, or argue about things. And that's probably why so many people do it so often. Don't like a restaurant? Post a negative review. Hated the new movie? Rip it in the comments section on YouTube. Think someone's YouTube video sucked? Oh, great. We definitely have ways of letting them know. But here's the thing. We're called to be different. That's a fact. The Bible tells us as Christians, as believers, followers of Jesus, we ought to be different from the world around us. But a lot of times when people look around, all they see are people who look the same as them. Why? Because Christians can be some of the most ungrateful people around. That's you and me, okay? That's us. We're known for being pretty ungrateful people. We're more known for what we're against than what we're for. 2022 has been a pretty good year for me. I became a dad. My band of 10 years had its last show back in April, and it was super fun. And this month, I celebrate 8 years of being the student pastor here at the chapel. But it's also been 2022. One of the most difficult years ever. I've had a lot of difficult seasons as well. To be totally vulnerable and honest, maybe you didn't know, my last grandparent passed away back in July, and his funeral was in August. And on top of that, I couldn't go because it was the first time that I ever got COVID. I wasn't even able to go see him, be a part of it, be with all my cousins, my family. I had to miss the whole thing. And back in February, the water line to my house totally ruptured. I woke up one morning, we had zero water pressure. I looked outside, our whole driveway was flooding. My neighbor's driveway was flooding. It leaked everywhere. And then 3 days later, my hot water heater broke. It just stopped working. I had to fix it. Life is full of ups and downs, loaded with them. Literally, from now until we die, it's going to be that way forever. But here's what I know. David told us at Motion Night that gratitude is a choice, not a feeling based on our circumstances. He was so spot on with that. Why? Because the reality is, through all the ups and downs that life tosses our way, we've got to know that we choose our mood. Feelings change on the reg every single day. And I learned late in life, so I'm trying to help you early on. I learned late in life that I'm in charge of my own choices. No one, absolutely no one, makes me do anything. I have the power to choose. I have to take responsibility for myself. I want us to look at Psalm 100, verses 1 through 4. In the New Living Translation, it says, "Shout with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him singing with joy. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. He made us, and we are His." Isn't that so good? "We are His people, the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gates with thanksgiving. Go into His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name." Notice how it doesn't say anything about when you feel like it or when things turn around for you. My Bible, your Bible, does not say, "Praise Him when you want, when it's convenient, when no one's looking, when everything in life makes sense, or only when He answers your prayers." Worship the Lord with gladness. Why? Because He has been nothing and done nothing but good things for you, always. Isn't that so good? Always. He has always done good things for you. I want you to sit in that. Think about it. Come before Him with singing and joy. Why did they write that? Why are we supposed to come before God with singing and joy? Because He deserves it. We didn't die for our sins, and now because of Jesus, we don't have to. He did it for us. He deserves every song we could ever sing. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. Why? Because I think the reason we're so ungrateful is because we're so self-focused and we're so selfish that we don't even realize God has provided in as many ways as He has. When we acknowledge that He is God, we also at the same time realize that we are not. We are the sheep of His pasture, the psalmist says. The Bible calls Jesus a good shepherd, which He is. He cares for us deeply and carries us over His shoulders like a little lamb when we've lost our way. No other religion has a God that cares so deeply for us that He'd be willing to carry us on His own shoulders like that. So because of that, because He cares for us like that, because He carries us on His shoulders, we enter His gates with thanksgiving, with praise. That's His church. His gates are wherever His people are gathered. So that's His church. That's your house party. That's your small group. That's FCA. Whatever it is that you go to, that's a Jesus-themed thing, that's His gates. Tell Him thank you and praise Him even when you don't feel it or see the light in the darkness, because He's there. Is that hard to do sometimes? You'd better believe it. But is it worth it every single time? Absolutely it is. Chapel students, I'm grateful for you. I have the best job in the entire world, and I want you to know that I love you guys. So to close us tonight, I want to lead us in a prayer that I wrote down to close tonight's message and turn our hearts toward God in gratefulness, to change our mood and our attitude into one of gratitude. My hope is that for praying for you right now, and that you hearing this and praying this over yourself, you can see what God has done. You can see what this can look like in your own life and do it yourself. Sometimes if you don't know what to pray or how to start praying, you can just start off with thankfulness, by thanking God, and things can go from there. So I want you to close your eyes. Everyone in your room, everyone in the whole house party, wherever you are, close your eyes and just rest in this prayer. I wrote this prayer for you. I'm praying this over you tonight, chapel students. So God, we come before You and we're just grateful. We want to change our mood, our attitude, to be one of gratitude. Personally, I want to thank You for giving me the strength to get through this week. Thank You for giving us a little bit more summer weather, and thank You for being so kind to me when I don't deserve it in the slightest. And I praise you, God, for these chapel students who are finding life and community and purpose by attending this house party. Thank you for your presence, which finds us anywhere and knows no boundaries. There's nowhere we can go to hide from your presence, and we're grateful that you seek us out. You desire to be close to us. Forgive us for wanting to drift away and be distant. Give us the faith to trust you when everything around us is crumbling and when we feel like being bitter or complaining about our circumstances, no matter how bad they may be. Help us to see where you are still moving, where you're still active, and making us more like you. In the powerful name of Jesus, we hope, we trust, and we pray. Amen. We'll see you guys next week. Have an awesome rest of your house party. Tell your host thank you. We'll see you soon.